Warner Super Bowl Rap Show is presented by Genie. A wet and wild day at the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl. Games going down to the wire at the ESPN Wide World of Sports. Semifinals in Division II have been eventful, entertaining, and dramatic. As we welcome you to the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie, I'm Tom James. We will take you through all of the highlights in all of the brackets, and we will start with the games that have just completed here at the Wide World of Sports Complex, the Unlimited Division, and Gilbert Chandler up first against Greensboro. First quarter action, the Hitmen doing it with defense. They tackle William Mack McKenzie in the end zone for the safety, and it's 2-0. Later in the second quarter, Michael Keane going deep. A wide open Quade Swearingen finds his way into the end zone. It was 10-0 Hitmen. Still in the second quarter, about a minute left. Pass is picked off by Greensboro's Jaheim Brown. Greensboro unable to capitalize on it, though, before the half. As we move to the third quarter, about 8 minutes left to the air. The Hitmen's Dominic Hall with the INT and the big run back across the 50 before he was run out of bounds. And then on second and goal, Quade Swearingen again. The quick touchdown, 24-0 was the final, and Gilbert Chandler is on to the championship game. As we take a look at your final stats, and the thing that really jumps out at you, the last two lines, 0 for 6 on third downs for Greensboro. Credit to Gilbert's defense, and 5 turnovers forced. That was the difference in the game. The game of the day, St. Pete and Apopka. The war on the I-4 corridor. Joaquin Lohman runs the ball, about 25 yards, bobbles it, recovers, and then moments later, Eric Wright takes it in for the touchdown. And it was 14-8 Apopka in the third quarter. Darryl Kelly III down the sidelines, working his way into the end zone for the score, and that would tie it at 14 apiece. Fourth quarter, about 9 minutes left. The Silver Raiders' Nicholas Caldwell scores the touchdown. They led it by 8. But just moments later, there goes Eric Wright all the way for the score. 22-20 was the score at that point. Under 6 minutes left. The fumble, Kedrick Murray on the recovery. He takes it to the house for the touchdown. Silver Raiders on top of Apopka, 28-20. A huge goal line stand that you saw at the top of our show would finish it off. And St. Pete wins a thriller over their neighbors in Central Florida. Apopka, 28-20 the final. Can't wait for that championship in the Unlimiteds. 3:15 Friday afternoon, St. Pete against Gilbert Chandler. The consolation games, we're out of breath here. New Haven and Lee's Summit, second quarter, and Ryland Fine catches the pass for the first down. Moments later, Timothy Cashier Jr. cashes in with the touchdown, and the Broncos led it 6-0. On to the fourth quarter we go. Biding time, going downfield. Dominic Myers intercepts the pass, thwarting the threat. And then a little while later in the fourth, the Broncos go to Myers on the ground, and he is outrunning everybody. 88 yards to the house. 13-0 was the final in that one. We've got more action still to come on our Genie Pop Warner Rap Show at the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl. Stay with us, we're coming right back.
Disney Soccer Showcase is the ultimate place for top clubs and players to be seen by hundreds of top college coaches looking for great soccer talent. Rated the number one youth soccer tournament in the U.S. in a Soccer America survey, Disney Soccer Showcase gives athletes a chance to shine on one of the biggest and best stages set for youth soccer in the country, here at ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex. For more information, visit DisneySoccerShowcase.com.
Pop Warner Super Bowl Day 3 at ESPN Wide World of Sports, and some nifty play calling all day long. A fun day of football. We welcome you back to the Pop Warner Wrap Show, presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. Now it's time to check out the Junior Peewees, and that's how we started the day. Point Loma and Titletown in the semifinals. Point Loma doing it with defense. They call it the Disney defense, and it was magic. Getting the sack right down near the goal line. Then in the second quarter, the Pointers get on the board. Kendall Johnson up the middle for the touchdown, and it was 8-0. Later in the second, Jackson Emerson, this time through the air. A great catch. Little dipsy dude brought down around the 11-yard line, and that would lead to the Aaron Lee 22-yard field goal to make it 11-0. Then in the third quarter, Point Loma. Kendall Johnson again breaks to the outside, and they won't catch him. Into the end zone for the touchdown, 19-0. Pointers. And then on defense, Aaron Lee, same kid that kicked the field goal, gets the INT. Point Loma into the championship game on Friday, 25-6. Over Titletown. The other semi, Southeast Dallas and Ohio Elite. Gregory Howard breaking through tacklers, and he would be gone in the end zone for the touchdown. The Panthers on top, 6-0. In the third quarter, the punt hits one of the linemen, picked up by Jalen Hicks. He takes off down to about the 40-yard line. Later in the possession, the Panthers, Malik Walker recovers the fumble. And then in the fourth quarter, still a 6-0 game. Wolverines still not on the board until DeAndre Jackson catches the touchdown pass, the extra point, 4-1. Kevion Williams catches the pass, a dramatic finish as the Wolverines advance to the championship on Friday in Junior Peewee. Southeast Dallas against Point Loma, 8:30 Friday morning right here on ESPN3. It should be fun. And how about the consolation games? East Bay and McCadenville. And the Dolphins look to Justin Rockymore, and he's running wild. Finds his way inside the pylon for the touchdown, and McCadenville went in front 7-6. In the fourth quarter, same score, first play of the quarter, and Carmelo Bass is in there to make it a 13-6 game. Still time left. Jamiroquai Golden catches the pass, and he keeps going, keeps those legs churning down the sidelines, eluding all kinds of tacklers and in there for the touchdown. It was a 13-12 ball game, but Carmelo Best would put the icing on the cake, run it in for the touchdown, and McCadenville, a 20-12 winner over East Bay. The other consolation game, Lenape Valley against Milford. First quarter, the Indians. Matthew Lavalier catches the pass and outruns the defender who can't catch up with him. He's in there for the touchdown. The two-point conversion made it 8-0. Still in the first quarter, Lenape Valley, Carson Wakefield this time. All the way down to the 5. And Lenape Valley was in business. Carson Wakefield again runs it in for the touchdown. 14-0, Indians led it at that point. Looking for more in the second quarter. And he breaks free. They can't bring him down on the double handoff. The touchdown, 21-0 was the final as Lenape Valley is a winner in the consolation brackets. We've got more highlights coming up when we come back from the Pee Wees. Stay with us on the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie.
Disney Field Hockey Showcase is the premier event for the nation's fastest-growing sport. With over 100 college coaches in attendance, female high school athletes can contend for scholarships on the national stage. To find out how your team can compete here, visit DisneyFieldHockey.com.
Pop Warner Super Bowl, Fort Osage with a big pick. Exciting plays all over the complex. Semifinals from Division II today. And let's take you to the highlights from Pop Warner Super Bowl, Fort Osage with a big pick. Exciting plays all over the complex. Semifinals from Division II today. And let's take you to the highlights from the Pee Wees. Northwest against Redwood City, and the 49ers looking to punt. Corey Washington waiting on it inside the 50, works his way right and to the outside, dances down the sidelines, the tightrope into the end zone. It was 6-0 Northwest. Then they go deep to the air. Mark Evans with the reception, and he tiptoes into the end zone for another score, 12-0, Falcons on top. In the second quarter, it's already 18-0. Redwood City throws it right to Mark Evans. The pick, the stiff arm, and he's in there for the touchdown. Late in the half, Corey Washington again. He did it on special teams. This time he takes the screen pass 50 yards for the touchdown. That would engage the running clock, and the Falcons looking dominant, defeating Redwood City 41-0. And the Fort Osage game against Wilmington, no score, second quarter. Larry Jones turning it outside and turning on the Jets. They won't catch him. He's in there for the touchdown, and it's 8-0. In the second quarter, the big INT, it's Trayvon Robinson for the Indians, headed back the other way. They'll finally bring him down around the 20-yard line, but that would lead to this. Roman Tillman takes it in for the touchdown. 14-0 Indians. On to the second half, and David Jaquez picks up the fumble, the scoop, and score. Fort Osage rolls in a shutout, defeating Wilmington 28-0. So that sets up the championship. 11 o'clock in the morning on Friday in the Pee Wee Division, Fort Osage and Northwest. Something has to give because both these teams looking very, very dominant. From the consolations, Hyde Park against St. Augustine. No score, third quarter. It's fourth down, and St. Augustine gets stuffed. Later in the third, Kaimani Flourme catches the pass, fights his way in for the touchdown, and the Cowboys take a 7-0 lead. On to the fourth quarter. About 3 minutes left. The Saints, with the ball on the ground, they recover the fumble. And then with under a minute left, unable to get in the end zone. The pass was incomplete, and the Cowboys win 7-0 was the final. And from the Bluefield consolation, Watchung Hills and the Monument Blizzards first quarter action. Jake Mamoli, they won't catch him. He is into the end zone for the score. Extra points were good, 8-0 in favor of the Wolves. In the second quarter, William Black on the attack. He's in there for the touchdown, 14-0 at that point. Second half, same score, and they give it to James Palea. And he breaks free from a crowd and finds his way to pay dirt. 20-0, the score at that point, and Watchung Hills goes on to win the final score, 32-8. We'll take a quick break. Coming back with your junior varsity highlights when the Wrap Show, presented by Genie, continues.
Let your rising soccer star play and learn alongside greats of the game at Disney Soccer Academy. This unique camp experience features age and skill-appropriate coaching, along with daily interaction with superstars of the game. To find out how your child can participate, visit DisneySoccerAcademy.com.
Thrilling action all day long at ESPN Wide World of Sports. Welcome back to the Wrap Show. We've got one more set of brackets to get to. And that's in junior varsity as we welcome you back live inside our Genie studio. So let's take you to the highlights in junior varsity. The semifinals, Riviera Beach from Jupiter, Florida against Oak Cliff. Mistake. On the handoff, Harry Mason recovers for the Chargers. Later in the first quarter, Xavier Scott takes the pass all the way down to the 1 yard line. And then on third and goal in the second quarter, the quarterback sneak, Trayvon Taylor in there for the touchdown, and it was 6-0 Riviera Beach. The rains started to come in the fourth quarter, still 6-0. Xavier Scott takes the handoff, 25 yards into the end zone for the score. And then more Chargers. Anthony Hankerson taking the handoff, 17 yards for the touchdown. And the Chargers are on to the finals, defeating the Oak Cliff Titans 24-6. The final there. In the other semifinal, Hoffman Estates against East Orange, Justice Fitzgerald sacks the Hoffman quarterback Ryan Smith, and then Al-Shadi Salam down the sidelines and into the end zone for the touchdown. Actually pushed out at the 10-yard line, and it would be Salam that would take care of business and score. As we move on to the second quarter, 6-0, East Orange on top. Bowling his way in for the score is Ryan Smith. That made it an 8-6 Hoffman Estates lead. Rain still falling. Ryan Smith carrying the football down to about the 30-yard line. And finally, in the fourth, they give it to Smith. Busting tackles all the way across the goal line for the touchdown. And the Hawks win a battle over the Jags. 14-6 was the final. As we show you the brackets and how they set up this championship game Friday, 1:15 here on ESPN3 for all the marbles in the junior varsity division. Consolation games from JV: North Raleigh, the Bulldogs, against the Patriots from Warwick. First quarter, North Raleigh already on top, 8-0. Jacob Gill with the over-the-shoulder catch down the sidelines and into the end zone. The team from North Carolina on top, 15-0. On to the second quarter, the Bulldogs go to Christian Lyons. And he catches the long pass just across midfield and in a foot race. He's dragged out inside the 10-yard line. That would set up another score right there. And North Raleigh would go on for the big victory. 33-15 was the score. And the last consolation game from junior varsity, the Almaden Mustangs against the Hanapepe Colts, one of the best games we've seen all week. Almaden, Camilo Arquette takes it in for the score as he moves the pile into the end zone. It was a 15-8 Almaden lead. In the fourth quarter, a little over 7 minutes left, Makoa Vanaman, the long run to pay dirt. That pulled Hanapepe to within one at 15-14. But Almaden would answer right back. The Mustangs giving it to Darren Martin. He gets loose and scores. 21-14, Almaden on top. Still in the fourth quarter. Going to the end zone for the game winner, Hanapepe. Harley Ragasa scores it, 28-21. The team from Hawaii wins a thriller. That's a look through our brackets, but the best part still yet to come. Our Genie top plays of the day are next.
Disney soccer tournaments sponsored by AS Roma provide athletes of all ages the opportunity to compete against athletes from across the U.S. and around the world. From three-on-three youth tournaments to elite showcase events with hundreds of college recruiters present, the ESPN Wide World of Sports soccer program offers something for everyone. To find out how you can play here, visit DisneySoccer.com.
And of course, the Pop Warner Super Bowl, not just about football. The National Cheer and Dance Championships coming up on Thursday, live at 5 Eastern Time on ESPN3 and streaming live on the Watch ESPN app. Got a little unfinished business. Late highlights from the blue field here this evening. Consolation game between East Orange and Brick City. Jason Camacho catches the pass. They can't bring him down as he runs it in for the touchdown. The Lions on top 12-6 in the fourth quarter. A little over 6 minutes left. The quarterback sacked in the end zone for the safety. That extends Brick City's lead to 14-6. Then the Jags give it to Loxley Burke. A long run for the touchdown. That's the theme of the day. Long touchdown scampers. That made it a 14-12 game. And then East Orange. Matthew Zhao runs it in for the touchdown. It was 19-14 in the fourth quarter. The Jags then, Jasim Brooks fools the cameraman and everybody else in there for the touchdown, slips in the end zone on the wet field. 20-19, the Lions defeat the Jags in a close one. We have seen some incredible plays in some incredible games throughout the brackets today in Division II, but now the moment we've been waiting for, our Genie top plays of the day. Let's roll them, and we'll start with number 5 in junior varsity, Makoa Vanaman, running wild. There he goes, trying to go all the way back to Hawaii in one shot. 146 yards on 2 touchdown runs in the fourth quarter alone for Vanaman. Number 4 from junior Pee Wee, McCadenville. And Carmelo Bess going up in traffic, one-handed catch, pulling it down. Great play for the Dolphins. To number 3, junior varsity, the longest play of the tournament so far. The pass play, Connor Clark over the shoulder to Jacob Gill. Down the sidelines for the score, 92 yards in all. To number 2, from the Pee Wees, the Northwest Falcons. On the punt return, Corey Washington. Watch him tiptoe down the sidelines. 41 yards for the touchdown. Just keeping it in there and getting in for the score. And finally, our number 1 play of the day. Pee-wee's Northwest Falcons. Mark Evans with the INT. And watch the stiff arm right there. Gets him the rest of the way into the end zone for the touchdowns. Quite frankly, any of those could have been number 1. A full slate of games coming at you tomorrow. We will be back bright and early tomorrow morning from Division 1. Let's take a look at the schedule. Starting at 8:30, kickoff, Junior Pee Wees, Virginia Beach against the Western New York Bills. Followed at 10:30 in junior varsity, North Philly against Churchland. Then at 1:15 in the Pee Wees, Deer Valley takes on North Raleigh. And wrapping it up at 3:15 from the varsities, Dorchester against Santa Clara. So excited for the games tomorrow. Well, we always take time to remember our friend here at ESPN, head coach Jim Valvano. It is Jimmy V Week for cancer research. We've all been affected or know someone who has been affected by the dreaded disease. 1 in 2 men, 1 in 3 women will develop cancer in their lifetimes, the second most common cause of death in the United States. Of course, founded in 1993 by head coach Jim Valvano and ESPN. And if you would like to donate, you can log on to the website www.jimmyv.org. or call 1-800-4-JIMMY-V to donate. We've awarded more than $170 million in cancer research grants over the years. Well, that will put an end to an incredible day. Thank you for watching the Pop Warner Rap Show, presented by Genie. We'll see you in the morning.